students, now I am going to discuss the question number C of exercise 5.12. Divide until you get the remainder 0. See the first example. Here we are asked to divide the decimal number 32.4 by the whole number 5. So let us divide the decimal number 32.4 by 5 by the long division method. First of all, I am going to divide the first two digits by 5. So let us divide 32 by 5. 5 6 are 30. 32 minus 30 is equal to 2. After the digit 2, there is a decimal point in the dividend. So I am going to put the decimal point in the quotient as well, exactly over the decimal point in the dividend. Then the digit 4 will come down. So it's a 24 now. Let us divide 24 by 5. 5 4s are 20. And 24 minus 20 is equal to 4. Now the remainder is 4. But in the question, we are asked to divide until we get the remainder 0. Hence, to continue the division, we write 0 here. So it's a 40 now. Let us divide 40 by 5. 5 8s are 40. And 40 minus 40 is equal to 0. Hence, the quotient is 6.48. See the second example. Here we have to divide the decimal number 2.1 by 4. First of all, I am going to divide the digit 2 by 4. But the digit 2 is less than 4, right? So we cannot divide 2 by 4. So how many times 4 goes into 2? 0 times. So here I am going to write down 0. And 2 minus 0 is equal to 2. After the digit 2, there is a decimal point in the dividend. So I am also going to put decimal point in the quotient exactly over the decimal point in the dividend. Then the digit 1 will come down. So it's a 21 now. Let us divide 21 by 4. 4 5s are 20. 21 minus 20 is equal to 1. Now here the remainder is 1. Now to continue the division, we write 0 here. So it's a 10 now. Let us divide 10 by 4. 4 2s are 8. 10 minus 8 is equal to 2. Again the remainder is 2. Again to continue the division, what we have to do here? Yes, we again put 0 here. So it's a 20 now. Let us divide 20 by 4. 4 5s are 20. And 20 minus 20 is equal to 0. Hence, the quotient is 0.525. Likewise, you can solve the remaining examples given in your textbook in question number C.